Yo, what's up, guys? It is your boy Bugs, and today, guys, Multiversus has dropped their new developer series blog called Welcome Back Rewards, Battle Pass, and Economy Changes. Let's get straight into it. So, for all the players that will be joining Multiversus on May 28th, you're all going to get something free, which is Banana Guard. Banana Guard and Lady Banana Guard also. But only if you finish the tutorial and their 7-day reward calendar, and you'll be getting these characters and variants for free. And for my returning open beta players, don't worry, you're gonna get some free rewards too, but you're gonna have to be able to claim this stuff within 2 weeks. By June 11th, or you're gonna be asked out. But the rewards you're gonna be getting is the Season 1 Battle Pass for free, Jason as a character for free, a special edition Snowsuit Finn for free, a special edition Rising Star Ring out, and a special edition Banana Guard announcer. And as you can see, this is gonna be Finn, he's gonna be dripped out, and then that's gonna be your knockout animation. Next, guys, they're gonna be doing is a battle pass update, guys. Yeah, they heard our voices, guys, and pretty much they're gonna increase the high value of items that we've been begging for, more like more ring outs, more character variants, taunts, and currencies. What currency? Yeah, you heard me. So now we're gonna be able to earn premium currency, Glenium, guys, free version and the paid version of the battle pass. So even if you can't buy the battle pass, guys, over time you could accumulate enough battle Glenium to get a battle pass for free. And then when you actually are able to buy your battle pass, whether you do it with your money or through the free version, after that you don't have to buy the pass. You don't have to buy the battle pass anymore, because there's gonna be enough Glenium to be able to buy the next battle pass, which I'm pretty sure is like 1,000 is a battle pass, which is $10. But yeah, and also the Season 1 battle pass is going to be lasting for 8 weeks. And for the people like myself that finish these battle passes quite fast, the last tier is going to be repeatable. They're going to be able to keep playing and earning rewards until the battle, the season pass ends. And I'm pretty sure it's going to be one of the four or all four of the currencies that are new to the game. Let's get straight into that. Currency update, guys. I need y'all to clip this. I need y'all to put this on Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, everywhere. Open beta players that have acquired Glenium, character tokens, battle passes, and skins, all these items will still be available for you at launch. Remember that. You're not losing out on anything. You didn't get scammed. You're getting everything back on launch. Okay? Okay. Also, for the people that acquire like the character tokens and the battle pass tokens, you know, the founder pack people, don't worry, guys. You're still able to use it. Unfortunately, for the people that want to gain them in the present time, unfortunately, they have discarded that. But for the people that did earn them and had them on their account, you're still going to be able to use them. So for the next, you know, 20, 30, you know, character tokens you still have, you're still able to use that. For the next 2 to 3 battle passes that you still have, you're still able to use them. Don't worry. But, you know, you just can't earn them anymore. And now that goes into our new currency that they're going to be talking about, which is one, the fighting currency, and the perk currency. Pretty much that perk currency is just going to be to get perks in the game. And how to gain them is by through events, rift modes, battle passes, account mastery, and character mastery. Next is the fighter currency, which is how to unlock your characters. And how you can gain this is by events, rift mode, battle passes, account mastery, and character mastery. Next we have is the prestige. How you get this is by acquiring cosmetics. So I actually got to go back into this one. And then finally, Glenium. Glenium is how you unlock cosmetics, emotes, battle passes, and more. How to gain this is by through events, battle passes, and purchases. So you actually can earn Glenium by doing events. So I'm pretty sure like events that they're going to be doing, like bigger missions and like all that stuff is going to be away. But that's dope. But yeah, so the prestige thing. Pretty much how it works is each cosmetic item you acquire rewards its own prestige currency value based on the type and variety. Eventually, you'll use your prestige currency to unlock prestige cosmetics. So I'm guessing like an upgraded version of a cosmetic you bought. So for example, me buying Finn pajamas, I'm pretty sure like after me playing and accumulating points, makes me unlock prestige cosmetics, which represents the rarest cosmetic in the game. These items can only be unlocked using prestige currency. When you launch the game, again, for all the returning players that had amount of cosmetics, you know, people that bought cosmetics before the game was released, you know, in open beta, they will acquire rewards from all their purchases before, and pretty much get equivalent to it, like a price match type thing, where you can just get, I guess, a free upgraded version of your like skins. But finally, I'm pretty sure y'all noticed after seeing these four perks that there are no more gold. So what they're gonna be doing is for all the gold that you had, they're gonna pretty much, again, pretty much price match your gold to cosmetics to give you exclusive items that cannot be earned in any other way. So this is pretty much just like, yo, because you grinded and you had all these coins, we're just gonna give you free cool free skins. So if you are like me or like other people that gained a lot of coins or just didn't spend your coins, expect some cool like skins in your account that not a lot of people are gonna have. And then finally is the perk update, guys. So pretty much they noticed that there was only a few perks that people were using and a lot of them just weren't being used. So they removed a lot of perks, they reworked the favorite ones, and they added new perks that should enhance the gameplay experience for all the players in the game. And also we'll be setting perks and all that stuff. So pretty much all your perks are pretty much locked again. You got to get it. And then the final one that's going to hit a lot of people, including myself. So the mastery. Remember, there's going to be account mastery and character mastery. To make it fair, they decided to reset everybody back to level one for the launch. So it gives everyone a fair opportunity to rewards and their masteries and etc. And I'm pretty sure they're going to have new rewards in the character mastery and the account mastery. I know this hurt for people that was grinding. It was like level 30 and 35s and 40s. And I think the highest account was someone named Jesus. And he was like level 42, Shaggy. My God. But yeah, we're all going to be reset by level one. But it's okay because they're going to pretty much, like I said, price match our stuff, which is like the gold, the cosmetics that we bought and all that stuff. And yeah, can't wait to see y'all May 28th, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Gave you all the information you needed. Leave a like if you like it. Comment anything. You know, I love y'all comments. It's like talking to y'all. And if it's your first time ever watching one of my YouTube videos and you do enjoy Multiversus content, hit the subscribe button, guys. And I'm out. Peace. She got a man she don't really give a fuck about. Left him back home in a whole other state. Moved to LA because she want to be famous. Got another 5 on the side. She a waitress, but it's getting tough. Part of fun.